Okay, if you see combat people, people that do combat, they do not use the weapon the other way around. And there's a reason for that. They teach it that way because it's harder to drop it. You're not gonna do something, you know, silly that way. So when they're doing this, yeah, I can go in and hit it, which is, that's the perfect technique. But if you're going to do this and go here, the punch comes in. Okay, so I'm gonna go here, turn, hit the hand down, and then go for the snap. Okay, so you're going here, pow! And this motion allows this to keep it slow. Always stop the hand. What's he gonna do? He might draw this back. Boom. You understand? So I want you to think at this multi-dimensional. I'm not gonna do this with the rest of the techniques. It's not one technique, it's not just this. That's great if that happens, but if it doesn't happen, think outside, boom, and bring it in. Okay? And think what happens when the other hand comes in. Okay, let's do it. So if he does this, I might do this. Boom. And now, here. Okay, because I need to shock him because I don't know if he's going back.
No, he'll fly back.
Well, if he flies back, I'm okay with that. But if it doesn't happen, then I'm here. You might also try something similar to this. If this comes across, it's actually to go ahead and break it here and throw in an elbow. Again, he can catch you. On that, he might be able to pull you back, so be careful. Everything has to do in life with what? Timing. Mm-hmm. If you get the timing done, nothing can be take away from you. I wanted to go to China, and everything failed when I wanted to go. But the year after, everything happened for me. Why? It's timing. Life has to be about timing. Let's do it. So anyway, this is fantastic. This is a nice extension. This extension means also that you can draw back that much. Okay? So this to me is similar to this. So I'm gonna go here and I just pull completely out because he's so deep. But the reality is he might be crossing on me. So he has an extension and there's my move. But this has to be in to go for the break. So, I actually expected you to grab and do that.
No.
No, well, from this close?
Yeah.
Keep going. I expected him to grab. By the way, he didn't get me off balance. If he would have pulled me off balance, now it's hard for me to go ahead and do the movement. By the way, when he sticks you, don't worry about the knife right now.
Stick him.
Yeah, here. Bam! I'm sorry. I'm gonna come across this way as fast as I can, and I'm gonna try to grab the elbow again. I'm gonna try to grab the elbow, but I still ain't gonna have it. So I'm gonna, as he pulls back, I go into the kneecap. But traditionally, what do you wanna do?
Tenkan, you mean?
Yeah, traditionally, he's gonna go here, you're gonna go here. But the reality is he's gonna grab you. You're gonna lose your balance. Boom, sorry. Here, and then from here, I wanna kick him in the groin, but that knife is sticking out. Okay, so when this happens, okay? So,
you get good groin.
So let's do it. So as this comes in,
the slash or the
slap? You're gonna actually pull me in so you can slash. Boom. You know? Or cut. I wanna be able to do this right here, rotate, and come across this way. If he's giving me a hard time because he's a big guy, you push across. Okay? Because it's there. So when he pulls, boom! And turn. Okay? Let's do it. Okay, so in Aikido, there's two different processes. If he's coming overhead, you can actually do this, doing a Rinnai. Perfect, nothing wrong with the technique. Then you'll have people do this. Come, same thing, show me. Here, they lift it up this arm and then come in with a hit. Those are both correct, okay? If you have an extension this far, it's traditional, perfect. If it's a bat, it's slightly different. It's never overhead attack. It's always gonna be slight angle to it, okay? Knowing that, I have to come in. But if I'm way over here, do you feel like coming in? No, and a lot of people do this. Try to get in this way. And what happens is when you normally get there, you lose your balance anyway. So what you need to do now is actually stop the arm from here. Where I'm actually doing EQ here. I threw in the strike to soften them up, rotate it down to the ground. It doesn't matter here. I don't want to fight him, so I take his knee out. This is a really fucking hard thing to do. Because if he hits my hand, okay, he's going to break it, and I get one hit. So I have to make that hit count. Because my hand might be broken. So instead of blocking like this, let's do this now. Why? Because it's fat. Boom. So if I'm going to take the hit, I like to take it right here. I'll take it here if I have no other choice, but don't do it this way. Okay? Because that's the bone. So I'm going to come here, boom, lock it up right here. You can do all kinds of fancy shit and throw and all that other stuff. Take him down as fast as you can. Boom. This is good. This is good. Just take him down. Okay? If you hold on to the weapon. Okay, when I'm doing this, hold on. He's not giving. Who's going to give him the damn stick? Yeah. Nobody's going to give him. Push that down to his groin. Boom! Right on top of the head. Anything going to the groin, he's going to stop it. He shifts around to get that, not to get hit. You get him on top of the head. I know, it happens to me all the time. I'm at my house, he's always trying to stop it. I spoil him so much. Let's do it.